Hello guys, and welcome to my YouTube channel. So in this video, we are going to be addressing all controller issues related to EA Sports FC24 PC, the PC version. Yes. So this video has been divided into simple steps that you can easily follow to make sure that your controller works and you can have a very wonderful experience playing the game. So let's get right into it. What you are going to do is that we are going to check if the fault is not actually from your controller. We are going to check if your laptop or your computer is actually detecting the input from the controller itself. So from here, we'll head to the Windows and type setup USB, so it pops up. And as you can see, you should see your controllers connected. I'm using a twin pad, so it's appearing as two. You can click any of them. If it's one, if you are using one, you see just one, and make sure that when you press your buttons, it senses the inputs. You can try all your buttons from X, Y, whether triangle or circle. Make sure all the triggers and the bumpers work. Once you are certain that they all work, you can just close this tab. Press OK. So now our controllers work perfectly. Then we move on to the next step. Okay, so we need to download an app called x360ce. It's a free app. You can find it online. The link will be posted in the description below. So you can just head to your web browser and search for x360ce. Download. And just click the first results. It should take you to their website. And you simply download for all games. I recommend this one, but you could download 64 bits based on the specifications of your device. So I normally download this one, which works perfectly for me. So you click on download. And it downloads. Yeah, so when it's done downloading, you head to your downloads folder. And you just extract the file. You should see x360 appearing as an application. So I'm going to do that. I'll extract my file. So I have already done it. So we'll move on to the next step. So now in your downloads folder, you are going to extract the application. You can use WinRAR or any other third-party application that suitable. So we extract it. We have it in our folder here. From there, we're going to open it. And we can run it as administrator. Click yes. So in this case, we are now going to add a controller and configure it so that it will be able to work in the game. So in order to do that, we'll go to this green button here, the cross, add. Then look for your controller. If your controller is connected, it should have a green sign allocated to it, and it should have been ticked. All my connected devices are green. Mouse, for example, is green. And I said my controller, I'm using a twin USB gamepad. So I have two USB gamepads, which are currently green. So yours may be one. So when you are done adding, you add selected. You should see your controller here. And once you move your buttons, it should be recorded at this location. You see it's being recorded. Now what you are going to do next is that you are going to configure all your buttons. So that means when you press a button in the game, that same input will be recorded. So we do that for the trigger. The bumper. The back button. The start button. So you basically do it for all your buttons. Just to ensure that you work rightly in the game. This is the right analog stick, so do it. The buttons. So you do it for the left analog and the rest. Once you do it for this portion, it should satisfy this portion. But to double check or to be sure, you can redo it again. So once you are done with all this, you can configure your another controller using controller 2. You use the same process. You are just going to add, and you add the next gamepad. And you do the same for that. Now once you are done with all that, you are just going to press save all. One more thing to notice is that if the light here is red, it means you haven't really connected your controller well. You make sure you go back and add the controller, and it should be indicated by a green light, just to be sure. When you are done, you save all and you just minimize the app. You are not going to close the app, you are going to minimize the app. Once you minimize it, you should see your x360ce appearing here. Once it appears here, it means that whatever key you press is going to appear in the game, or you are going to be able to control your controller in the game, to work in the game. So from there, you go on to launch your application and it should work. So if it worked for you, like and subscribe and comment in the